My understanding of our theology is that it's important to believe that sin entered the world through Adam and Eve. But what I don't quite understand is if Satan was created by God and perfectly in union with God prior to sin, then why would his pride exist, or why would he ever choose not God, even with his free will?
There's an element of mystery here. Now, in the case of both humans and angels, God gave us both free will. So we both had the ability to choose either for God or against God. And that means that even though, in fact, it was the devil that tempted our first parents into sinning, that didn't have to happen. They could have sinned without Satan tempting them. In that case, the temptation would have, or the decision would have been theirs in the absence of Satan putting a temptation on them, and it would have been less likely that they would have fallen, but it still would have been possible. And in the same way, God gave angels free will, and that involved, just like it did with us, it involved what theologians sometimes call a probationary period, or a period of testing. And in that state, it may have been the case, and we don't really know this because we're not told about the fall of the angels. We're told that it happened, but we're not told how it happened. So we have to be comfortable with a little bit of uncertainty here, with a little bit of mystery. But it's possible that just like Adam and Eve would have been united with God in immortality if they had passed their probation, it could be that the angels would have been further united with God if they passed their probation. And that did happen for the good angels, but for the angels that chose against him, it did not. And so it's possible that they were not fully united with God. They had the opportunity of becoming fully united with God, just like we do, but there obviously was room for them to misuse their free will, and some of them did. Exactly the psychological dynamics of that, you know, and what happened are difficult to understand, in part because sin is irrational. It is never a good idea to sin, but people do it anyway. And so we can have some insights based on our own temptations and, you know, what experiencing temptation is like, but that's harder to apply to an angel because a lot of our human temptations are based on our bodies. You know, we have a desire to eat too much or a desire to have too much physical pleasure. And angels don't have bodies, so they don't have sensations. They don't have temptations in the form of bodily sensations, but they must have something that would move them to consider rejecting God, and some of them did. But ultimately here we're dealing with a mystery, and we can only know so much about it because only so much has been revealed to us.